Premier Barry O'Farrell is being accused of kicking the poor as he slashes money to public housing. So let's go straight to state political reporter Josh Murphy, who has the exclusive on this story. Josh, exactly where are these cuts being made and felt?
Well, Sandra, these cuts affect every public housing tenant, especially those living in homes in urgent need of repair. $37 million has been ripped out of the maintenance budget. That's when there's already people who've been waiting 5 years, in some cases even longer, to live in a home which meets basic standards.
It's just one scene of many. Five skip bins are so rusted through, the rubbish is left scattered at the entrance to the public housing block, attracting vermin. Just nearby is what's meant to be a communal laundry. It's unusable, instead used as a drug den, littered with discarded needles. Inside the units, it isn't much better.
And it's also started into the bedroom in there.
Judy Schultz's unit has rising damp, causing the paint to peel. It's been like this for 5 years, despite numerous complaints.
It's full of very decent people. All they want to do is to live, get on with their lives.
And tenants claim it will only get worse. The public housing maintenance budget was $195 million. It's now been slashed to $158 million in this year's budget, a cut of almost 20%.
There are rats everywhere, carpets are ripped, there are leaking bathrooms.
Jim Cummins is one tenant whose carpet needs replacing, one of many much-needed repairs, throw in rising damp as well.
It's been damp all the time I've been here, and I'm a bronchial person. I've got bronchitis and asthma. They won't do nothing. They just tell you to bugger off, really.
Speaking of that, the Finance Minister, Greg Pearce, wouldn't talk about the neglect on camera, only to say new maintenance contracts will focus on getting better value for money.
It's actually shameful that Barry O'Farrell and Greg Pearce have allowed this situation to deteriorate.
Tenants want an immediate cash injection to improve the worst of the living conditions.
Now, Greg Pearce, who is responsible for spending on public housing assets, is also the minister who charged $900 to the taxpayer for a private trip he took to Canberra and then repaid the money. The opposition is urging him to take a trip here in his own backyard to see how more money should be spent on these estates, not less. Sandra.
State political reporter Josh Murphy, thank you.